Hey everybody, I'm John Swantek. Welcome to the latest installment of Match Play. Here's the way it works. Three topics to be debated by two people from our expert panel. I'll decide who wins each topic and determine one champion. Let's meet this week's combatants. Matt Adams from the PGA Tour Network, the host of Fairways of Life, weekday mornings on SiriusXM, and Sports Illustrated senior writer Gary Van Sickle. Matt will lead us off for topic number one. Camilo Villegas was disqualified last week at the Hyundai Tournament of Champions when a television viewer noticed a rules infraction and posted it on Twitter. Matt, should television viewers be allowed to weigh in on rules violations?
Absolutely not, John. I do not believe that people watching an event on television should have an influence on the final result. To me, it's no different than when we watch a hockey game or we watch a football game or we watch a basketball game. We're all screaming at the television. We all feel that we saw infractions that should not have happened, that should have been caught by the referee. But absolutely, there should not be a time where one turns to the fans or even the media for that fact and says, what do you think about this? Should we take another look at this thing?
Gary, are television viewers custodians of the game in some respect or just snitches?
They're both. I think the bottom line is I'm not a fan of spectators or TV viewers affecting the rule. However, the fact is a rule was broken and they were the watchdogs who caught it. The problem with this whole deal is this rule about after the fact with discovery, Villegas gets disqualified. I believe scoring errors, if they're correctable, should be corrected. You find out later that he committed a penalty, he's got a two-shot penalty. Okay, we add two shots to the score, he keeps playing. I wish fans wouldn't call in, but if they saw an infraction, they saw an infraction, and it ought to be called.
It's a game of integrity. We've said it 1,000 times. You call penalties on yourselves. It's what makes the sport unique. I'm going to give topic one to Matt Adams. Topic two, Gary Van Sickle will lead us off. We're talking fantastic finishes. Last week's winner, Jonathan Bird, of course, holed out in sudden death to win in Vegas late last year. But Gary, was that a better hole out to win a tournament than Asao Aoki's eagle in 1983 to beat Jack Renner at the Sony Open, this week's tour stop?
You know, that's a tough one. I'm going to have to give the edge to Aoki just because he was playing his ball as it lay. I don't remember. I think he was in the rough, if I recall. You know, Jonathan Bird playing in the dark, of course. If it hadn't been a par three, they wouldn't even have gone on. But he's able to tee his ball up. He's going to have a perfect lie every time on a par three tee box. You know, they're both pretty amazing. I got to go with Aoki just because I got to believe it's harder to hole out from a fairway no matter where you are, no matter what the distance than it is with the ball teed up on a tee.
Matt, it was a great shot. Was it better than a hole in one to win?
Well, I have great respect for Gary, as you well know, but he's wrong again. Here's the thing. Timing, the drama that was involved, you have to take it in the context of the fact that Jonathan Bird was on the cusp of losing his card. And yet, through the darkness of Las Vegas, in a playoff, he knew that he was working that ball from right to left to a back left hole location that was very difficult to assess. Yes, he didn't see the ball fall in the hole, but he sure as heck knew what line he was sending it on. It was an absolutely brilliant shot, and for everything that it represented, the drama that it had at that moment, it was a much more significant shot. It could have been the greatest finishing shot to a golf tournament ever on the PGA Tour.
Well, I was going to go with Aoki, but Matt presents a strong, broader argument there. I'm going to give topic two to Matt Adams so Van Sickle can merely salvage a moral victory at this point. Matt leads us off with topic number three. We're talking rookies, and there'll be a lot of them in this week's full field event at the Sony Open, but Matt is the eventual 2011 Rookie of the Year in this week's field.
Well, Gary's going to crush me on this one because I'm taking a complete unknown in the likely 2011 PGA Tour Rookie of the Year. I'm going to go with Louis Oosthuizen from South Africa. You know, when you have a rookie on the PGA Tour that's that obscure, he's sure to sneak up in the competition. My pick, Louis Oosthuizen.
All right, Van Sickle, Jamie Lovemark seems to be the odds-on favorite. Is he your guy?
You would be out of your mind not to think Jamie Lovemark is the hands-down favorite to be Rookie of the Year. He was number one in the Nationwide Tour. He was 22. He was the youngest leading money winner in a Nationwide Tour ever. He's been successful at every level of amateur golf. He's 6'4", hits it long, great putter. So he's the obvious choice. If he's not the man, if he's not this year's Ricky Fowler, I'll be amazed.
Yeah, the only question is the expectations on Lovemark. But I'm with Van Sickle on topic three. But Matt Adams takes this installment of Match Play 2-1. Gentlemen, thanks for the time this week. Well played.
Thank you.
Thanks. I'm taking the immoral victory. Thanks.